Shalom and Salamta Rastafari. Today is October 11th, 2012. Let us listen to what wisdom has to say concerning leadership. What greater wisdom than that which is greater than even Solomon's? The wisdom of Ayandad Father, first power of the Trinity, His Imperial Majesty. Kedamawi Kaila Shalasi. And so, let us listen to what our Father has to say concerning leadership, because there is a video we recently viewed. It's on YouTube, and the individual presents many different forms of opinion, assumption, speculation, ideas, point of view, of which they present what they think leadership is, should not be, what a leader does not do, whom they thinks is a leader, whom they assumes is or is not a leader. And so a whole bunch of mix-up, and Rastafari don't deal with mix-up. And so let us listen to what our Father, Him that is wiser than even Solomon, has to say concerning leadership. And let us begin. Leadership does not mean domination. Let us pause right there, because in this spiritual warfare, it is necessary to know our enemies and know what the enemy is capable of and what they do. And it's nothing new. Same tactics since the beginning. But we must be aware and knowledgeable on their game, you know, on what it is that they do, so that we are better prepared. We've already been granted and given authority and dominion over them. But in order to exercise it, we must know. And we must not guess or think or believe as these individuals do in their practice. But we should know. And if we don't know, then we find out. We seek in and through Christ that perfection. Rastafari, don't go to the left, to the right. We either know or we don't. But ultimately, we do know, because if we don't know, we just get to it and due diligence and, you know, show ourselves approved by studying, and thus resulting in Ayandad, you know, being workmen, need not be ashamed, rightfully dividing the word of truth, dividing right from wrong, receiving right and casting away wrong. And so these individuals attempt, you know, the demons, them, the wicked. And okay, just for the record, ones that are captive of demonic forces or wickedness aren't necessarily wicked. They're not themselves. They have been overcome and are captive of wickedness, of demonic activity. For instance, pride. If one is full of pride, it's not necessarily the individual. The person could be of good intent and stuff like that. He's only held captive by pride, by that certain demon. So leadership does not mean domination. Let us make mention that in spiritual warfare, we must not limit domination to, or anything for that matter, limit anything to in this warfare to the physical, but rather accept that this is spiritual warfare. This is both physical and metaphysical. And so let's not limit the word domination to only the physicality that we are confronted with on a daily basis, but rather let us review what the individual uploaded on his video presentation. You know, he makes mention, he gives ideas of what he thinks leaders are or are not and stuff like that, but then he takes the liberty of deciding of dominating the thoughts of other individuals without the other individuals so much as being present or even having a word in this. For example, he says, oh, he that thinks he's a leader, he that thinks because of this and because of that. See, that's demonic activity right there, whether he be aware of it or not. And let's not, I mean, it's not to disrespect the brother or even go up against them, but rather we should seek to help them, because from what I've been able to receive, he's not even aware of what's going on, and he's captive of a demonic force. and it's we'll get into it, but he's like he's in